Well, this is luxury, Bluey.
Yes, love. Client's desk, client's armchairs, client's pictures, all flat.
Oh, I like it.
So do I, love. Right, let's get the money over, then we can talk. You're four and a grand on top.
Oh, you don't have to. It was an ordinary loan.
Inflation and appreciation. Mine. You bought the lighting, love. How about a client's drink?
Oh, no, thank you.
Client's cigar? You still off the yard, Stan?
Yeah.
Yeah, so am I. Oh, I tell you what. I've got some Soho Madeira. That's a real treat.
Why not?
Yeah, I'm doing well, my old spider. And I'd be a bloody liar if I said I didn't like it.
You'll be a mug.
Yeah, too right.
Cheers.
Cheers. How long this trip?
Oh, no, I've turned in my card. I'm going shopping in Calcutta Monday for Indian miniatures, selling them through Charlie Warren's.
Oh, they came from Warren's.
Oh, yeah. They're above board, are they?
Favourite. Oh, crime's gone, Dad. Finish this football. There's no laughs anymore, no fun. All you've got's a load of madmen running about with shooters, being chased by the law with shooters. All your villains are politicos. IRAs are robbing the banks. And the Freedom Brigade, whoever they are, captured a pay. You read that in the Standard yesterday?
What?
Two jock nationalists held up a chippy in Camberwell with a bloody hand grenade. Well, where's the joke in that, Dad? Because what it comes down to is old Bill can't distinguish. He collars you climbing through some tough MP's window, and you find yourself being beaten up on a political ticket.
Yeah, that's true.
No, I got out just right.
I should have joined you on that photographic course.
The old pulley.
Mm.
Ah, they were all nutters there too, lad. I was so straight. Believe me. There, it was worth it. I make more in a month on this lot than I ever made with the heavy mop. I bought the house in Weybridge. I've got two nice boys, and it's all legit. Okay, so I still knock out a bit of pawn now and again. That's almost kosher these days.
Still with Big Betty, are you?
Of course. And what's the point in changing? Anyway, I don't like models or actresses. All skin and grief.
You don't often enjoy leaning on people, Sarge. Warren didn't know what hit him.
Yeah, well, for my money, he's as bad as Scott. Bent as a corkscrew, Derek, my old darling. Only sleepy with it.
Where to now?
Back to Nick. Well, I was in the military place in Germany a long time ago now. There's a programme on American Forces Network called Music's No Mystery.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the signature tune was by Duke Ellington.
I didn't know you liked jazz, Sarge.
I don't. But, see, I can never work it out. And now I have. I'm reading a book by a Spanish bloke called Unanomo. I don't understand much of what he says, Derek, but what he does say is that everything's the opposite to what it seems.
Well, I suppose you could say that, Sarge.
Yeah, you see, he says that things are not what they seem, but what they are, which is, by definition, the opposite to what they do seem. It's called a paradox, Derek.
This is psychology for your promotion exam, sir.
I know, Willis, and it's not psychology, it's philosophy. Helps you understand why people change orders and contradict themselves. Makes you accept mysteries.
Oh, yeah.
Off.
Well, I really came round to take Spider down the Cardinal for a beer.
I know, he phoned. He's meeting Charlie Warren at the gallery.
I really, well, I'll go and wait for him down there.
You know you're not allowed to drink, so wait here.
I'm going to do an article on him for the column. Get him some publicity for this Indian trip.
There is. I know you, Ray.
Only work.
I think journalism's had me. Good days, and I'd hardly pick up the phone, let alone talk to anybody.
You're not worrying about you and me, are you?
Actually, I am, if you want to know.
I'm going to tell him about us.
Very nice little collection you've got here, Mr. Warren. That's a very nice little sketch. Picasso, indeed.
Quite fair. Couple of Somerset Maugham collection. The writer.
So I believe.
Well, I never read none of his books, but he had some lovely pictures. And what's interesting about this one is it happens to be virtually unknown. The old fella kept it at his villa in Cape Ferrat, south of France, but because he didn't like it, he hung it in a maid's bedroom. Be with you in a minute, Spider.
Excuse me. Good evening, Mr. Scott. I hoped I'd find you here. Excuse me, Mr. Warren. I wanted to apologize for this afternoon. I was very rude.
What are you doing here?
My card, in case you change your mind.
Well, it's very flattering, Mr. Fairfax. Pray there's no chance.
Oh, very well then. Goodbye. Thank you, Mr. Warren. I liked your sketch. I wish it was hanging in my bedroom.
Thank you, sir. Who is that geezer?
I don't know. Some punter that wants me to do a job for him. I never met him before today.
Come in the office.
Right.
Smoking when I'm depressed.
Well, it's better than drink.
I mean, you wanted one.
Well, I can't smoke with Spider around.
He's right.
What's with you? You're always different. You're always on the move. You never stay in one flat for long. You never stay with one bird for long. You know, those 2 months you were with me, I really thought we could have made it. I'd even have finished with Spider. I still would if you'd give it a proper try.
I can't live with anybody.
Yeah, you prefer whores, you dirty bastard. I saw you chatting up that slag at Pater's.
Maybe.
You weren't unfaithful when you were with me.
How'd you know?
Well, I can tell.
That's all right, then.
I don't know. Tell Spider I'll ring him tomorrow.
You're going to be sensible, aren't you, Ray? I mean, it would only hurt him.
Yeah, I said so.
Well, you better take this, then.
Ah, my Mrs. Beaton.
Yes, I found it this morning. Nostalgia, you know. Something else.
Thought I banked it.
In the name of P.G. Reynolds.
Pen name, darling.
Spider, my son, I could have told you I was buying a collection of Georgian glass. I could have told you I was buying Chopin's piano.
Right.
And you wouldn't have believed me.
Right.
It's a day at the races, £4,000. Answer that, fella, love.
Let's get it straight, shall we, Charlie? Borman told you himself. He warned you off.
Yeah.
You never met that Fairfax before.
On my baby's life. He came in here 2 minutes before you did.
crazy, isn't it?
It's a real nose. But you see where I stand, Spider. Any break-in of any house with a Charlie Woman picture on the wall and Bullman's in here asking questions. That is his promise.
Yeah.
I'm vulnerable. I can't afford it, son. I'd be finished.
I'm going to have that, Bullman. I'm going to find out what's going on.
Oh, tread easy. Be careful, son.
Someone's put the boot in. I can't work for anyone in this game now.
That's about the strength of it.
Routine DI-5 report.
Rumour around the bistros. They don't know what her background was.
No, it seems not.
Shall we pick her up?
I think that'll give substance to the rumour, don't you?
Well, nothing about the photographs.
Just a silly girl boasting to her friends.
Well, if one of our chaps have heard the talk, you can bet someone else has. There'll be a lot of interested parties. KGB, CIA, and the South African Intelligence Services.
Rhodesian Black Underground's pretty active with London as well. It's their second home.
I think it best to hand the whole thing over to DI-5 while we're still ahead of the field.
But then everybody'll know about it.
I'm talking about a get-out, sir.
How do you mean?
Well, cover the track. Send the girl home.
Yes?
Our South African friend retires with a diplomatic indisposition. Loss of a good man through...
Through what? Viral rhinitis, I suppose. Retires to an orange farm in a town to breed landrace pigs. You're an ass, Fairfax. Recent events have convinced the South Africans they've got to pull their fingers out. Now they've appointed a negotiator of Van Rin's calibre. We can't allow his position to be undermined because of a 10-minute tumble with a black lady.
Yes, sir.
This is a one-off job, Fairfax. No fuss. I want that negative, that's all. What's your progress?
I believe we've found our man, sir.
Excellent. You're retiring soon. It'd be nice if you left on a high note.
Yes, sir.
Perhaps might find you another job. I believe you lost a packet on the market recently. And you do have two ex-wives, support.
That's correct, sir. But I must warn you, you could fall flat on your face over this.
Oh, no, Fairfax. I'll fall flat on yours.
You're making up for lost time. Mm-hmm.
And this guy was at the gallery waiting.
Talking to Warren, yeah.
Couldn't have told you then.
No. Mind you, Maggie did tell him that Warren and I were in business together.
So that's where he knew you'd be. He probably waited, went in, then was prepared to wait again. That's how I do it. I call it doorstepping.
Oh, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Hello,
Warren. Don't look so baffled. Famous man in your line of business. That's Patton Garden Jump. Big Tom, Spider, the drainpipe.
Yeah.
Everybody knows you're free. Down to big bidders.
And you don't think that's worth a story?
I'm sorry, old lad, I don't. I mean, what's it about? The ex-con who can't go straight because Sergeant Borman, CID, warns off his business partner. That angle won't work because Warren won't stand it up.
No, he won't.
Mm. Well, the ex-con's being tempted back to the paths of unrighteousness by some hooray amateur punter. Probably wants his compromising letters recovered. What's his name again? Tell you what, I'll hang on to this. See if I can find out who he is when I got a minute.
Bullman should be exposed, Ray. It's malice.
I'm not surprised. You've not exactly done him any favours.
He reckons I've got in the way of his promotion. I'm going to complain to Superintendent Cummins.
You're crazy. Look, you should take Maggie away on a holiday. You've only been out a day.
Rubbish.
Go and get yourself a suntan.
No, I'm staying here where the action is. Do you want another drink?
Well, it'll just make you belch. Well, I must get moving.
Working today.
More interesting story than mine.
That wouldn't be difficult. Some little girl, it seems. Been having it away with a foreign diplomat.
Clearly. Yeah. I'll give you a ring tonight.
Yeah.
About Cummins.
Right.
Oh, Trev, I'll have another one of those.
Miss Parsons, Miss Margaret Parsons.
Yes, what do you want?
Where's CID officers, miss? Can I come in for a moment?
Look, I've only just got up.
I'm Sergeant Bullman, miss. We have met. I prefer to talk inside. Saves embarrassment for the neighbours.
Scott. Yes, yeah, all right, I'll see him. Fetch him up, will you? Oh, let me have his file first.
Right. What is your occupation, Miss Parsons?
You know what I do.
I want you to tell me. Will you?
No. And if you want something specific, say so.
You're not hostile to the police, are you, miss?
I bloody am to you, Sergeant Bullman.
Dear, dear, dear. That's not very clever, is it? Especially when you cohabit with a well-known criminal.
He's not a criminal now.
How do you know? He's only been out 24 hours. Oh, that's a very interesting book, though. And I take it that Scott is your steady lover. You don't object to the term lover, do you? I mean, you're not his wife or his sister, are you, miss?
Look, we know about you and Warren, and you're being reported.
Oh? To Inspector Denman? Or to Chief Superintendent Cummings?
And the parole board.
Oh, dear, dear, dear. The parole board as well. Well, I shall have to watch my step then, won't I? Everything by the book. I see you enjoy a little smoke.
What do you mean?
Filters for joints, Miss Parsons. We shall have to get our doggy down here, won't we? See what he can sniff out. Never mind. It'll keep. See, what we're inquiring into is stolen minor works of art. I take it you have receipts and provenances for everything on display here.
Yes.
Good. Let's have the shopping list, then, shall we, Derek? Ta. Let's start with this Lalique bowl. Isn't that nice? Oh, signed. As I remember rightly, a Mr. T. Farley of Holland Park lost a Lalique bowl, amongst many other things, last Christmas Eve.
Look, I got it round the corner in Portobello Market.
Got the receipt handy?
Off a stall, and I don't always get receipts off stalls.
Victimisation.
Bullman. Why pick on Bullman, Scott? He's only a sergeant, does what he's told. You could say I've got it in for you, if that's how you want to put it.
And I thought it was a malice of a stupid copper who'd been passed over for promotion.
Really?
Why? Haven't you read my reports?
Oh, yes. But I'm in crime prevention, Scott. I'm not having you in a high-risk business. Oh, come on, grow up. Look at the information you'd have access to.
Prison's a deterrent, Superintendent. I had gate fever this time. I'm not going back there again.
Try another trade, Spider, but don't apply to the Bank of England.
Don't deserve your reputation, Mr. Cummins. There's some people about who say you give them a fair crack of the whip.
Yes, I can do.
What else can I do? I got my degree in there, Nick. Didn't you read that in the reports?
History of art. Useful subject for a specialist cracksman. They used to learn plumbing in less sophisticated days.
Yeah, I can see the sophisticated days haven't impinged themselves upon this shop. What are you going to do, ban the subject from the curriculum?
Now, come on, get off your high horse, Scott. You've been to prison 3 times, probation before that, and that's just what's in the book. You're a crafty bastard, so don't come to me crying victimisation. You put yourself there.
Self-righteous indignation doesn't suit your form.
Thanks for marking my card. What do you want me to do, muck about an oil rig?
Delighted. But you get no special privileges in West London.
Right.
Oh, by the way, we're inquiring about a burglary at Holland Park last Christmas.
Oh, yes, you'd do well to hang that on me, wouldn't you? I was in Nick at the time.
We got most of the big stuff back, but the flotsam, it's beginning to turn up around the markets.
So,
don't go slanging my boys when they pay a visit on your lady friend asking for proof of ownership. On your bike.
Not doing very well, are you, miss? See, it's not just for us you have to keep your books straight. We're thinking about the income tax and the VAT.
Look, it's not for resale.
Well, another for the private collection.
That's right.
She's the antique dealer who's got nothing for sale.
Well, there's those two pictures.
Oh, I'm sorry, yeah. Ah, two pictures for sale. You did say you hadn't got another shop or warehouse or offices, didn't you, miss?
Yes.
I don't know how you make a living, miss. Still, I think we will tell our friends at Customs and Excise. They do enjoy these interesting cases.
They're bastards.
Seal it, is, will you?
Did you bloody try?
Anything in it, sir?
Nah, Derek, she's just a cowboy that doesn't pay her income tax.
What about the pot?
We'll see. We're just finishing, sir. Would you mind waiting in that room for a moment?
The bedroom? I've come for lunch.
Just for a moment, sir. We're police officers.
I will if Miss Parsons wants me to.
No, I don't. They've been going over my things.
Have you a warrant?
It's just an inquiry, sir.
What's your rank, officer?
Are you a dealer, sir?
Name, rank, number, and division.
Give us another St. Clement's marker. And don't spare the orange juice. It's me, not one of the William Hickey boys.
The other reporters, they don't come in there so often these days.
Cut our expenses.
Bleeding to death.
Well, maybe you better have this one with me, eh?
Why not?
Why not? Who cares? A lot of fun's gone out of life, eh, Mr. Ray? It's no fun anymore.
You're all right. You come from a farm in Florence.
Listen, if I had a farm in Florence, I'd open a bar.
Back in
You've got to get out. No, I'm not kidding. They're going to do you.
Someone rang me this morning. I didn't answer.
Yeah, that was me. The word's out on you.
Oh, Christ. What am I going
to
do?
Now, you're booked on the 6 o'clock flight to Kingston. It's time to visit your grandma.
How come?
Got your plane ticket and £200 cash. Just want you to tell me who took the photograph.
Oh, I don't know.
Now, listen, Lucy. I may not be able to help you soon. Now, you leave, you wait for me outside, I'll follow.
What about George?
Be on there.
One St. Clement's.
Thanks, Marcellino.
She's a stupid whore, right? Excuse me.
I know.
You know me? I'm the king of the wise monkeys.
Good drink.
Whoever you are, Fairfax, it's difficult to be rude to a man who brings his own lunch.
And flowers.
You know, you remind me of the Brigadier.
What regiment was he in?
No, he was a con man. He sold Harrods, lock, stock and barrel to Sheikh Faisal.
Oh, well, perhaps that's my future, Mr. Scott. Have you got any glasses, Miss Parsons?
Yes, I think I'll put that food out in some plates.
Have any more thoughts about my offer?
Yes, and the answer's no. I'm sorry.
I could run to 15,000.
15,000 now? What's the job?
We want you to recover something that's been stolen from us.
You sound like Ian Fleming.
Less exotic, but similar.
Well, why didn't you tell me that when you first came here?
You didn't give me a chance.
Now, Charlie Warren's.
I'm still making up my mind.
Yeah, well, you got the police to lean on me. You tricky sod.
Well, you weren't the only candidate.
Superintendent Cummins, eh?
The police know nothing about this. It's far too important to have Men like Cummins and Bullman flat-footing around.
You devious bastard.
I could perhaps minimise the possibility of your being caught, but I can give you no protection if you are.
You don't give much away, do you?
Not yet.
What am I stealing?
It doesn't matter to you. It's in a safe, but it's of no intrinsic value.
Oh, don't give me all that. No intrinsic value. All right, then make it 20 grand.
$15,000. You break in, you get out, and hand me an envelope when you come out. That's it, nothing more.